Welcome to the Accenture Innovation Hub in the wonderful Zeche Zollverein in Essen. Today we would like to show you how to make a drone part of your workforce and do automatic inspections using artificial intelligence. Many companies use drones already in day-to-day inspections to track progress of construction and so on, but they all do that manually. So you have a big drone, you control it manually, you take pictures, videos and so on, and then analyze it all manually. And today what I would like to show you is how to have a fully automated end-to-end process, starting from the scheduling to the actual flight execution and then the analysis. And the first step that we are going to do now is the scheduling. In our example, we use ServiceNow to schedule the inspection. You could, of course, also define regular inspections on a recurring basis, but here we do that manually. Of course, you could also use other tools like SAP Plant Maintenance, for example, to do the same. I create the inspection order. For example, to check if the fire brigade way is free and not blocked by someone. So, and I simply submit that here. And then the next step is happening in the actual drone scheduling and drone flight solution. We now switch to the HHLA Sky drone management, flight scheduling and flight execution software, which is remotely controlling the drone. Generally speaking, you first need to set up the missions once. So in our case, now the inspection mission has already been created. It's around our innovation hub here in Essen. And we have a clear flight path where it's supposed to fly, and it's taking pictures then, which are then post-processed. The next step is now the only part that you need to physically do at the drone. Everything else can be done remotely. What we do now is a so-called pre-flight check. I need to go to the drone and check that it's actually ready. So it's similar to a checklist that a pilot would do before they start with a commercial plane, for example. So I need to check my surroundings, the hardware is okay, batteries are okay, and so on. And once all of this is confirmed, I can then activate it. Now it's done. Now a pilot, which could be sitting somewhere in the headquarters or somewhere else, can take over. The pilot gets information about the weather conditions right now. Applicable, there's also current information about no-fly zones or other information from the aviation supervision here that if there's a problem. So I can now select the mission and start it. Due to legal reasons, I always need to have a pilot who's supervising it, because this person is responsible and is also then necessary in case there's an emergency. But in general, the entire flight process is then automatic. So I now upload the flight mission to the drone, check it. I can double check that it's the right drone, and now I am lifting off. The drone now starts and is executing the flight. I can also, of course, have a look what it's doing, looking at the real-time pictures from the drone. In case of an emergency, it would do an automatic landing. I can also take over control in the worst case if the automatic process is going wrong. I can, for example, initiate here an emergency landing remotely. We are now doing the second step that has to be manually done directly at the drone. It's the post-flight check. So we see the drone has landed. I need to now confirm that it's all in order. Log files are being downloaded. I removed the batteries. Hardware looks okay. Payload looks okay. So I can confirm done. In the background, ServiceNow or SAP is constantly updated about the progress of the flight and the inspection. for example, here that it's still work in progress. After the post-flight checklist has been completed, ServiceNow or SAP plant maintenance is informed that the inspection has been completed and that the task is done. The missing piece is, of course, the analysis of the pictures or the video taken by the drone, because I don't want to analyze it manually. I want only the alerts being notified to the people so that they can analyze if there's really a problem. So in our case, we did the check here of the entrance here of our building, and there's a car parked here directly in the fire exit. So that's not okay. So we have an alarm for that, that this is a problem. To summarize, drones are really useful when inspecting areas that are hard to reach because they're high above. If you want to have a different perspective to watch from above again, to inspect things that are dangerous, like a refinery flare, so a big flame, that is when it's an operation you as a human wouldn't like to go to very close to. So for these, drones are really useful. But in general, most companies do then the whole post-processing fully manually. So this means sometimes going through thousands of pictures. And therefore, for recurring events, for example, inspecting an asset, if it's complete or not, we could then train the AI to see, for example, oh, there's a misalignment of an antenna, for example, or something is missing after a storm, or I can look if there's the color of the surface has changed. So the example that we showed with the fire exit is not really very sophisticated, but we have a large number of different other scenarios where you can train an AI system relatively quickly to reduce the load on the engineers. Besides the technical aspects with the drone, AI system, training the AI to find something, there's other elements that we shouldn't forget here. So you need to, for example, get the special approvals to be allowed to fly autonomously. You need to train your pilots and your crew that is maintaining the drone. You need to set up the processes that are also part of the approval to get the okay to fly autonomously, that you set up the really rigorous processes for the flight operations and so on. This is all doable. It's not a very gigantic effort, but it's something that shouldn't be forgotten in that process, and where Accenture can help. And all of this combined is then allowing you to realize quite some productivity gains in many inspections that you do in bigger sites. As mentioned earlier, this doesn't apply everywhere, so it has to be a bit repetitive. It has to be, of course, visual from the outside that they can use a drone. These are factors that can then help to offload some of the effort from the engineer, highly paid engineers that you have, to rather focus on the findings here that are coming from the drone instead of really reviewing everything. And overall, this is then a really, really interesting new opportunity to improve and automate and more routinely, so basically have the same level of quality of all the inspections, because they're always the same. They're always filmed from the same angle. They are always using the same time, for example, to check things. So that can also improve a bit of the consistency of the checks and improve the quality of the data checks that you're doing here. I hope that you found that interesting. Please subscribe our channel if you are interested in more. And of course, please contact us if you want to implement such a solution in your site.